Good morning, class 6 students. Welcome back to Google Classroom, supported by Sri Gokulam Public School, Guruvayur. This is your mathematics period and we go through the chapter 14, Practical Geometry. We have found in the previous classes to draw the perpendicular to a line segment through the given point. Today we plan to discuss the perpendicular bisector to a given line. Then first of all we have to learn what is a bisector. What is a bisector? A bisector is something that cuts an object into two equal parts. It is applied to angles and line segments. In verb form we say that it bisects the other object. Here we discuss the case of bisector to a line segment and later we will discuss bisector to the angles. So here we can draw perpendicular bisector for the given line segment. Perpendicular bisector means it bisects and the angle between them will be 90 degree. Perpendicular and also bisects. Okay, so you can watch the video. Perpendicular bisector of a line segment. Perpendicular you know very well, but what is bisector? Bisector is a line which divides the given line segment into two equal parts. So, if it is we draw a bisector, that bisector should divide the given line into two equal parts. If you draw a bisector to an angle, then this bisector, that means this line will bisect that angle into two equal parts. That is the bisector to an angle. Here bisector to a line segment. But perpendicular bisector means that line should be perpendicular. Moreover, it divides the given line segment into two equal parts. Okay, that means the meeting point of these two perpendicular lines should be at the midpoint of the given line segment. Midpoint. Okay, so here we can construct the bisector, perpendicular bisector of a line segment. First step, draw a line segment AB of any length. To this line AB is we are going to draw perpendicular bisector AB. Then with A as center and a radius, that radius should be more than half of AB. Draw a circle. That I will show how we will take more than half of AB. Then again B as center we will draw circle with the same radius. Then these two circles will meet at two points. Let it be C and D. Then CD will be the perpendicular bisector. Then you can verify using your divider. That means this meeting point of these two points, let it be O, then you can check AO and OB are equal. Then only it will be the bisector or O is the midpoint of the given line. So we can draw the perpendicular bisector to the given line segment. Let AB be the given line segment. To this AB we are going to draw a perpendicular bisector. That bisector should divide this AB into two equal parts. That means that line should meet at the midpoint of AB. That means bisector. Okay, understood? So, yes, you will use this bisector in geometry everywhere. Okay, so you should practice to use this word while you are doing the problems. Bisector or perpendicular, perpendicular bisector, etc. So here we are starting the steps. First step, draw the line segment and we should draw the perpendicular bisector. For that, take the compass and place the compass tip at A. That means you are going to draw a circle with A as center and more than half of the radius. More than half of AB as the radius. More than half means nearly this one will be the midpoint. Then take more than that half
and choose this as the radius, we can draw circle or arcs. From B also with the same radius we will draw like this. So we will draw an arc like this. Arc or circle. Okay. Meeting at two points C and D. Okay. C and D. Then this C join C and D. Join C and D. This CD meet at AB on HO. HO. Then this CD is the perpendicular bisector of AB. CD is the perpendicular bisector of AB. Perpendicular bisector of AB. So we can check whether this O is the midpoint. We can check whether this O is the midpoint of AB because we are drawing the perpendicular bisector. Then this line should divide this AB into two equal parts. Understood? So we can check with the divider. So children, you check with your divider whether AO and OB are equal in your drawing. So divider used to measure correct length. You remember that. So we here we can use the divider to check whether AO and OB are equal. If children, we are doing only one activity. So you practice it more than two times today itself and practice well. Thank you. We can meet in the next session.